Good afternoon, students. Those who are present, just in the chat box, just to type it as present for your attendance. We'll start in 2 more minutes because a few students are joining now. So those who joined, please in the chat box, just type it as present. Okay, we shall start for us because often they might take some more time to join the session. Okay. So, the previous class we were discussing about the cloud part, we were just discussing just a short view of what we had. Is it audible, students? Is this clear? Hello? Check. Is it audible and clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Fine. Hey Ranjit, did you? Is there anyone who checked this TeamViewer?
Sir, we did it, but it's not showing other apps. Just calling itself, it's coming in the TeamViewer, sir.
Okay. Okay, not an issue. Okay, just to make you understand that. Okay.
Sir, okay. Sir, but we have did in any desk, sir, me and Ranjit.
It works,
yes, sir.
Yasin?
Yes, sir. Okay. It's working there.
You want to give a demo now, or how is it?
It's depend on Yasin, sir, if he is ready to do.
Yasin?
Yeah, yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. You can take the control of, you can present now and do it. Okay. Others, who has it? Srinir, is it? Yasin, kiske paas hai?
Sir, me and Ranjit, sir.
You and Ranjit, okay. Yeah. Ranjit, just click on present now from the screen and just start it. Others, just have a look at it, how it actually works. Okay.
Okay, sir. Hello, Yashin.
Yes.
Yashin.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, you can see on the screen, sir. It's showing like this. It's a remote button.
It's my screen.
These are the some steps which Rashin, just open your camera. Is that opening the camera, Jashan?
हेलो।
हाँ यासिन बोलो। हेलो
ए ए
गेटिंग स्टक इन बिटवीन।
नथिंग नथिंग, कुछ नहीं कुछ नहीं।
ओके ओके। हेलो सर।
क्या रंजित,
या सर, इट्स शोइंग लाइक दिस इटसेल्फ सर, लाइक इट्स
या
गेटिंग
इसको
स्टक इन
नोट,
बिटवीन।
या वंस वंस द ओपन क्लास स्टार्ट्स अगेन वी वी कैन गिव अ डेमो इन द क्लासरूम एज वेल। ओके, कैन डू
ओके
दैट।
ओके सर। ओके सर।
या स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट दिस योर फ्रेंड्स आर ट्राइंग टू डू इज दे ट्राइंग टू टेक द कंट्रोल ओवर अदर सिस्टम। ओके, सो दिस कैन बी डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ क्लाउड। ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट वी कॉल इट एज क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग। यस्टरडे आई वाज जस्ट टेलिंग यू, if I'm going to be UK, I don't carry my laptop over there, but still I can take the control of my system, which is in India. Okay, so this can be done with the help of cloud. Okay, that's a short way to tell you. Okay, so that's a good effort by your classmates, what they did. So last year we used to do it on TeamViewer. Now there are many, many apps or we can log into that and do it. Okay, so today we'll be understanding marketing database and data warehouse. Okay, so marketing database and data warehouse, when I say the market, yesterday we saw this someone going to the outlet, giving Vaishnavi as an example. She goes to outlet, she buys something, barcoding will be scanned, everything. So just extra information about that, marketing database and data warehouse. Now product database is, what is that product she bought? We are checking about this. So Fortune Oil she bought, that's what we are taking into consideration in the yesterday's example. The same will continue with today's example as well. So product database, when we say students, what is that product the customer bought? Okay, that's what the marketer is going to check. The features, the quality and the quantity, everything, all the information the marketer is getting fed into the system about the customer, one. Second is customer database. Who is that customer who came to my outlet? So that is what the marketer is going to check. Yesterday I told you Vaishnav has one customer, then Ranjit has second customer, Yasin has third, fourth has Nagaraj. So these are variety of customers who are coming, but they are not buying the similar products, or they could be buying the similar products. So that is what the marketer is going to collect, the customer database. And the transaction processing database, when we say, how many days, or in a month, how many days do they come and do the transaction? Is it at the end of the month, or the beginning of the month, or the mid of the month? So the marketer is tracking everything. On the basis of that, he'll get the products into the market. In the traditional market, you might have told to your local vendor, kirana shop, by this month, then please get these products. Okay, whereas in digital marketing, you need not tell it to the vendor. The vendor is keeping a track of your transactions and is making sure that the product is available to the customers on time. So that's what we call it as marketing database and data warehouse. Okay, so if you see at the below diagram, okay, so that's very clear. Okay, you need not draw this diagram in the paper. Just to make you understand, I have taken the diagram from Judy Raymond textbook. Okay, so that's one of the easy example of marketing database and warehouse. Okay, now the very important part. Okay, any doubts in the previous part, students? Just now we discussed. Any questions for me? Okay. Okay, shall I move to data analysis and distribution? Hello. Okay.
No, sir.
Okay, let's start with, let's start with the data analysis and distribution. Please put a star mark if you got the printout of this, or as in the what we say online, just have a piece of a paper and jot it down. Data analysis and distribution, 7 marks question in your paper. A separate question will be asked on what is RFM analysis. Again, in this data analysis and distribution, 4 important types of analysis are there, but in that, one is very, very important for the exam. Many times it has appeared in the paper. What is RFM analysis? A separate question will be asked for 3 marks in your paper. So
So I said this is one of the important questions. The first part is data mining. Data mining, when I say a huge data is crunched into a very, very small form, you can check such data, we call it as data mining. Okay. Now, when I say this, okay, now take an example of your coming to this something called as data mining. I'll just share my screen as well. So if you see over here, data mining, when you come down and check this data mining, in the previous class also I was telling, could you please go to page, hey students, here in the page 17, the huge data is available. The huge data is available, the complete data. So this is an Excel form, all this data is available. If you check this, okay, the huge data is available, but the customer will be confused, what is this? The marketer, when he wants to do the analysis of the data, he'll be really confused what is this all about. But when the analyst in the company, if he'll make his life simple by just doing a very simple thing, is he's showing this in the Tableau, okay, and he's filtering everything, and if he's showing it to the his boss or else to the client. Okay, now if you see this, okay, let me zoom it for you people, make it as 150. If you see this, we are showing the, if you see over here, the red, amber, green, what we give, okay? Red is we are below 50% of the market share and we are losing the market. We have lost the market. Amber, when I say it's a win-win situation, we are not lost and we have not gained the market. So such market we call it as amber, okay? And there is something called as one, means I am doing great in the market, which is above 50%. My market share is above 50%. So the previous part, what we saw was the data was in Excel form, huge number of data was available, but when a layman looks at it, he cannot make out what is happening in the market, okay? Whereas when an analyst will look at it, he can crush the data completely and he can check what best I can do with this, okay? See, he has forecasted the sales on the right top corner. If you see, he has forecasted the sales, what is the expected sales in the coming year, everything he has made it very, very clear with this rough data. This crunching the data in a very short form and presenting it, we have mined the data. That is what we call it as data mining. We can go up to an individual data, or as we can, if given a chance, we can come up with the details of country specific, or as cluster specific, or as you can come up with city specific as well. So a huge data can be crunched. There are many, many tools. There is R in the market, there is Python in the market, which is doing great. There is Alteryx, Azure. Then Tableau. So these are the different tools where the data can be mined. Huge data can be, we can play around with the huge data. So see, that's a quite simple one. If you check now in the previous one, the person would be really confused. What are these numbers all about? What is no discount, volume discount, all these things would be a bouncer for the people. But when I crunch this data, I put it in a very well organized form, then any layman would understand that I'm highlighting the numbers as well, saying that red, I'm giving an indication saying that we are going to lose the market. Then amber, I'm saying that, yeah, we are in the win-win situation. Green, I'm saying that, yes, we have captured the market completely. So this is what we call it as data mining, the first part of it. Okay. Are you following, students, this one? Yes, no?
Yes, okay. So.
Okay. Fine. Your data mining. Okay. The first part, data mining is a process. Okay. Data mining is a process used by companies to turn raw data into useful information. That's what I told. Okay. The raw data is available. We made it in a very useful manner and we used it. I've given one example of groceries stores, well known as users for data mining technique. Okay. So supermarkets are one of the best examples again. Then comes customer profiling. The second part is customer profiling. When I say customer profile, it's a model of the customer based on the profile. The market decides on the right strategies. Okay. Now say for example, each and every customer, a profiling will be done by the marketer. Okay. Now let's take an example of Vishal is in Hubli. He goes to some mall and he makes a purchase of the cell phone. Okay. And next month, he'll go to the same mall and he'll buy a Bluetooth device, okay? Then after 2 months, he'll go to the same outlet and he'll buy, say, for example, charger, cell phone charger. Okay. Now, Vishal as one individual, we have made a profile of Vishal. Vishal, initially in the month of December or Jan, he bought a cell phone, then he bought the charger, okay, then he bought the Bluetooth device. So this is a profile of Vishal. Okay, the market is keeping a track of it. Okay. So whatever transaction Vishal makes, we are making a profile of Vishal and we are keeping it ready. What is that Vishal is expecting next? We are going to predict it, okay, because of the customer profile. Now he might come and buy a SIM card as well. Again, that is into our profile. A complete details about Vishal will be stored into our system. So that is what we call it as customer profiling. Is that clear for us? What is customer profiling?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then comes something called as RFM analysis. A very, very important question for the exam point of view. Most of the times asked in the paper for 3 marks. Okay. Either they'll ask this complete question for 7 marks, else this question will be a separate question. What is RFM analysis? Please explain it for 3 marks. So quite a simple one. Okay. One is what we say, recency, then frequency and monetary. Okay, recency, frequency and monetary. Okay, now recency, when I say time since last transaction. Okay, now let's take an example of Kiran as an individual. Okay, he bought, say for example, what we say, a book. Okay, or else, yeah, let's continue the book or as an electronic device in the month of Jan. Okay. After this, he never got into our website. Okay. Or say, for example, Varun, I as an individual, since 2015, I'm not active on Facebook. I have just logged out, I have just deleted my account and I'm out of Facebook. Okay. Since 2015. Okay. I'm no more into a social network site. One part of it is Facebook. Okay. So, reasons is, last time, time since last transaction, either you take an example of Facebook or else you can take an example of Amazon or any online site. Say for example, Snapdeal, Kiran made a transaction in the month of Jan 2020. After that, till date, he has not logged into our website. Okay. But we will be sending him the promotional message on his email every time. Okay. We are just tracking what best we can do so that Kiran can come back to our site. One, reasons. Second is frequency. Frequency, when I say, how many number of transactions did Kiran make in this entire year? The number of interactions the customer had with this specific period. Okay. He might have, say, Kiran logged in the month of Jan 2020 and he never logged in back. One. Or else he has logged in back, he is just checking the products and is coming out. So we are trying to know Kiran is planning to buy a cell phone or else he is planning to buy electronic device, but he is not able to buy it. Okay, we are just tracking it. But at the same time, what we do is we send him the related products or else the advertisements on his Facebook or else on Amazon whenever he logs in. Okay, the reason is very simple. He is planning to buy. He has searched for the product, but he has not bought it. So we are tracking that. That is what we call it as frequency. Frequency is how many number of traffic or how many number of times he has logged into the site. That's what we are checking. The frequency we are checking. And the third is monetary. Monetary, when I say, is Kiran buying cell phone every month? No, he is not doing it. But Kiran as an individual, he bought the cell phone, he is buying the related products of the cell phone in this particular duration. Okay. So what is that average amount as an individual by name Kiran is spending every month or else every year? Or else, yeah, every year. So that is what we are going to check about Kiran, how much amount he spent. Okay. So this is something called as RFM analysis. So one is recency, then second is frequency, and the third is monetary. So any questions in this RFM analysis, please let me know, students. This is how we can write in the paper as well. Take any X as a person and write it. Don't write it as Kiran. That the evaluator might think that your name is Kiran. So don't do that. Okay. So RFM analysis, one is recency, means last time since last transaction, after how many days you are logging in. Second is frequency, is how many number of transactions you make in a day or a month. So that is what we call it as frequency. Third is monetary. How much average amount you spend in making the purchases. So that is what we call it as monetary. So RFM. Okay. Very important question for 3 marks students. Most of the time asked in the paper for 3 marks. Yeah. Any questions? Are you following students? Is that clear?
And the last part is reports and rating. So all these things, whenever the marketer goes for generating the report, okay, it is a computer program, okay, wherein they maintain the database of the employees of the company, or say, for example, the customer database completely, they go for generating the report. So Kiran has one individual, Vishal has one more individual, has spent so much of amount in this particular quarter or in this particular year. So either you can make them as a paying customers, whatever they take a call. The company sets their own matrices and they take the call on doing the business. Yeah. Okay. Any questions in this? Please let me know, students. A very important part. Okay. So any questions? Any ambiguity? Please let me know. Let's data analysis and distribution. So one is data mining, then customer profiling. Then third is RFM analysis. RFM analysis has been RFM analysis, recency, frequency, and monetary value. So again, I would say then report generating. So data analysis and distribution, there are four important types of analysis in the marketing division. So one of the important questions for 7 marks in your paper, again, I repeat, RFM analysis, a separate question will be asked in your paper for 3 marks. Okay? So recency, last time when you logged in, or else what was your transaction, and frequency, how many times you made the transaction, and monetary value, how much average amount you spend in a year or a month. So that's what the marketer is tracking about the individual. So go through these points maybe for a minute or so. Any questions for me? Please let me know, students.
So,
yes,
sir. So I have a question.
Yes, madam.
So whenever I visit any shopping site, I search for a particular product. Then later, okay. I'll just get logged out from there, and just log in Instagram or some social medias. Then after, I'll be able to see that product.
Yeah.
Whichever product I have searched. So yes. Is that the same thing happens here?
Yes, of course, yes. Now, if you could answer me which site you visit, then that would be easy for me, or else I'll just plug in the example and tell you, okay? So say, for example, Mega, okay? You are in Facebook, a social media site, okay? On the right top corner, right side, okay, I'm doing a clutter over here. I'm just trying to put my advertisement to Amazon. I'm using platform. My platform is Facebook. Okay, I'm using the platform. I belong to Amazon. You are Mega as a customer, and you are into Facebook. I'll have a tie-up with something called as Facebook. I'll say I'll be using your platform to do the advertisement. Okay. So you might have logged into Amazon anytime, and you might have checked the product in Amazon. You have just come out of Amazon. Okay. But your account is linked with me. I'll take the help of Facebook, and I'll try to do the advertisement of my product into Facebook website. Okay. Yesterday, Steven was asking the question, backlinks. Okay. How to do the backlinks. Okay. So this is something we call it as backlinking. I'm sitting on somebody's back and I'm taking the support over there. Yeah. And this is how the tagging happens. Okay. We are going to do the tags with the help of cookies we can do, but here what you asked is, okay. So this is something I'm doing the backlinking on, sitting on somebody's back and taking the support and doing the advertisement of my product. Now you might be wondering, how can they track? Okay, your database is completely saved with us. And this is how we are going to track. Okay, it's a tie between the companies, Omega. And this is how we track. Hope I answered your question. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Next time, or else after this class, please do this experiment. Just type in the Google best MBA colleges, okay, and just come out. At the same time, after an hour or so, or else maybe, okay, just log into Facebook. You will get n number of promotional ads on your Facebook. It happens.
for sure it has to happen, no doubt in it, it will happen. Okay, the reason is quite simple. You are doing a search engine, you are creating a traffic in for some colleges, say for example, and you are coming out of that and you are going to log into facebook.com. okay, and these companies are tied up. Okay, so and they are going to generate more and more links over there, and they are going to sit on somebody's back and taking the support over there. Okay, so this is how it works. Okay. Yeah, good question. In fact, okay. So backlink, as you asked this question, even Steven asked this question after the class tonight. I had a conversation with Steven. Okay. So when we say this backlink, students, please understand there are two types of backlinks. One is do follow and do not follow backlinks. Okay. As you people have asked this, so let me explain you what is this backlink all about. Maybe in the unit 4 we thought of covering it. Backlink. Okay. Now say for example, Steven has come up with a blog in YouTube. Okay, Steven is updating about the bike rides. He's going to all over India, everything he's doing. He's uploading the videos. Now, Yasin has one more individual. Even he goes for the bike ride all over India. Now, Steven has covered Kanyakumari and he has made a blog and he's updated in YouTube channel. Okay, he has his own YouTube channel and he's uploaded the video. But Yasin at the same time, even he has gone to Kanyakumari. He says, Steven, good job. Whatever you have covered is really nice. But you have missed some places. Okay. So, viewers, please click on this below link and you can check my video. So, here, please understand what I'm going to do over here is I am taking the link of Steven. I'm sitting on his back and I'm asking him, okay, I'm asking the audience to check my link. Where I did this, I wrote a comment at the bottom saying that, Steven, you have done a great job. Whatever it did was great. But viewers, can you check this link as well? So my backlink was, okay, Steven was my backlink. Okay, I sat on Steven's back. I'm making the best results. The platform was given by Steven. To put it still more simple terms, okay, I was just telling you, there are two types. One is do follow and do not follow backlinks. Okay, when I say do follow backlink, okay, I am writing a blog on Google, okay, and I'm using the term facebook.com. Okay, I'm using wikipedia.com. While reading, please understand this is highlighted in blue color, the HTTPS. As soon as you click on that, okay, Varun was writing something on marketing in the Google. Okay, he wrote an article and I have taken the data from Wikipedia, I have taken the data, or else you can refer facebook.com, though blah, 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 I'm writing, okay. Now, when I'm writing wikipedia.com, if you click on that, then the page will take you to wikipedia.com. Okay, automatically it will take you to wikipedia.com. Now, please understand, Wikipedia traffic I created. Okay, I created a traffic for Wikipedia, but at the same time, I'm getting the traffic at the same time. It means I'm getting more hits, okay, at the same time. This is something do follow. And there is something called as do not follow. Okay, do not follow. When I say do not follow, if I am writing a blog in Google and if I am not writing wikipedia.com, facebook.com, just writing Wikipedia, if you click on that, nothing is going to happen. But if I am using www.wikipedia.com, then it is taking you to that particular site over there. So I am creating a traffic for Wikipedia, I am creating a traffic for myself as well. Did you get this? How the traffics are created? Mega, you got the point of what I am trying to say?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Others, is this fine? A very valid question, very good question asked by Mega. So this is how the system works for us, the digital platform. This is how it works. So whatever you do, everything is tracked in digital marketing. So you are, because in the previous class, I was telling you, a complete database in the STS model we discussed, a complete data is given by you to the marketer. So marketer is going to play around with your data. Hope that's clear. A very good question. Any other questions, students? Please let me know. Good. Ask those questions. That will be really helpful. Okay. Shall we go to the next part? Knowledge management matrices.
Yes, sir.
again 3 marks question in a paper, or more than 4 times it has been asked in the paper. Okay, most of the time this question has appeared in the paper. Explain TCO and ROI. ROI, you guys are very much aware of this, but let's understand in the digital marketing part why this is it. Now, you might be wondering, okay, Amazon is collecting the data and Flipkart is collecting the data, then Facebook is collecting, eBay is collecting, most of the digital platforms are collecting the data. But what is the use for them? Okay, to be very frank, the market is getting a much benefit from this. Okay, the database, you're giving it free of cost. He's making a very good use of this. Okay, he's simply not collecting the data from you. He is going to sell the products to you. A small data, whatever you're giving, say for example, your birthday. Let's take an example of birthday. Just now, Mega asked this question, so I'll be taking Mega into the example. Mega's birthday might be somewhere in the month of Jan, April, whatever it is, just a rough data. Okay, here, let's assume this Mega's birthday is on Jan 5th. Okay, now Mega has an account in Amazon and she has an account in Facebook. She has given a complete detail. So Facebook has one platform, it will wish Mega on this particular day. Okay, Amazon will also wish Mega on this particular day. And few marketers, what they do is, they give some discount coupons to Mega. Okay, saying that it's your birthday, you can come to Tanishq showroom and buy, make some purchases, flat 10% discount because it's your birthday. So they are going to build a CRM with Mega on that particular day. So this database is going to cost Mega a lot. Though she has not made a plan of buying on that particular time, only because of this message, she might make her mind saying that let me buy today because I'm getting 10% off on the purchases. Okay, so this is something ROI. I collected the database, I simply didn't keep it. I'll make the best use of it whenever a time is given to me. So that is where we call it as ROI. Then there comes something called as TCO. Okay. TCO, when we say students, okay, total cost of ownership. Okay, so here I've clearly written over here, largely a matrix used for the information technology manages TCO includes not only the cost of hardware, software, and labor, but data storage such as saving, reducing web server down, and labor requirements. So this, all these things, we made Mega to get into our account. Okay, we are spending human to track on it. Made one employee sitting to track this database. We are spending internet on this. We are spending the server. We are spending the cloud, everything. So to get one customer database, how much we have spent? Those, all those cost, inclusive of all those cost, we call it as total cost of ownership. Okay. Many times, freshers, when they join the company, they keep asking this question for one particular project. Say, for example, SLA, service level agreement with a client. Okay, a very important term, students. What is SLA? Service level agreement, we call it as. Okay, say for example, you are working on a particular project. The project, you are getting paid salary is 50,000. Let's assume this. But for that project, we are getting somewhere around 20 lakhs per month. Okay, now you might be wondering, I as an individual, I'm just getting 50,000, but company is earning 20 lakhs on this project. How? The cost of the labor, who is cleaning your floor, who is cleaning your table, the light expenses, the AC expenses, your chair, your system, your internet, your manager, your ops manager, your associates, everything is included. So that's what we call it as total cost of ownership. Okay. Means how much cost is involved to get this project one, and how much I should pay to my employee. So those, they say same thing. If Mega is in one individual, if I'm going to track the data of one individual, how much cost, how much gimmick I'm doing in the market, how much cost I'm spending to get this database. So all these things is calculation of that. So one is ROI, okay, and the second is TCO. A 3 marks question in your paper, students. What is ROI and TCO? Please explain with the help of example. What is ROI and TCO? Explain ROI and TCO. This is how they ask. Please consider this example and write it in your paper, how ROI and TCO works. Any questions in this, students? A very important term. Please let me know if there is any ambiguity, please let me know. It's clearly explained in the example. If that was not clear, then whatever we discussed, you can consider that. Any questions?
Okay, shall we start with consumer behavior? Hello? If you're going through the well and or start with consumer online.
Students, you are following the subject. Hello. Is there any confusion with ROI and TCO? Okay, shall we move to consumer viewer online? Hello, check.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So ROI and TCO, it's clear, right? Any confusion? Because last year, few students had great confusion in ROI and TCO. So I'm asking this. If it's fine, then I'll move to consumer viewer online. Okay. Okay. Let's start with consumer behavior online, assuming that there are no queries. Okay, fine. If there are no queries, fine. Okay. Consumer behavior online. As you already studied in the third semester, you had a subject by name consumer behavior. Okay, which you have studied it offline business, what you understood. Now, consumer behavior online, okay, the concept remains same, students. Again, I would say when I was teaching you digital marketing in the beginning of my class, I told you the same thing. The marketing concepts will remain same. Only the platform what we are going to use is digital. Okay, the digital marketing, when I say the traditional market remains same, the platform what we are going to use is digital. Okay, for here consumer behavior online, the customer is same, only thing he is going to use the platform is your digital platform. Okay, so how it happens, let's understand this consumer behavior online. How this consumer behaves online? Okay,
with an evaluation of the online communication through internet, customers now see online advertisements of various brands. Okay, it is fast catching up the consumer behavior of the consumer in the major source publicity, or as niche segment you can take, or as established brands which are doing really, really great in the market. Okay, now say the best example, let me explain you what is this. The consumer who was happily buying the products in the traditional market, going to the outlet and buying, now he has been enjoying the show which is in digital platform. Okay, a very nice demo is given by the digital marketer when you can zoom the cell phone, you can see everything. But the only drawback in the digital marketing is you can't touch the product and feel the product. I'm a bit talking about service marketing over here. You can't touch and feel it, but you can experience the product. You can read the features in the traditional market. Whenever the salesperson explains, only then you understand the features of the product. Whereas over here, you can type it n number of times and check for the features. You can do a comparative analysis of various brands at the same time. So that is the beauty about digital marketing. Okay, and the consumer behavior is very consumer is really, really happy with the digital platform. Now, coming to this something called as how this consumer behavior online works. Now, say for example, there are many online catalogs wherein you can check for the products. Then there are many websites and search engines are the best example for consumer behavior online. Now, consumer behavior has additional characteristics, students. Okay, there are many characteristics in the offline business of consumer behavior, but there are some more additional characteristics of consumer behavior in online market. Okay, when compared to offline market. Okay, now the first part is scarcity. Okay, when I say scarcity, when the product is scarce, it will create more demand, such as discount offered by limited time only. Flipkart uses this principle. Okay. Now, Flipkart and Amazon, they are leaders in doing this deal for the day. How many of you bought the cell phone or has waited for the marketer or as Amazon or Flipkart just to say that launch of the day or deal for the day? Did you do this anytime? You waited to kal launch or main kal kharidunga aisa kuch kiya anytime? Have you done this? Yes, no. Okay. Many might have done this, or as today people who said yes, you can just check this, go to amazon.com today or as Flipkart, okay, and just check for only two left in the stock, the books or as the cell phones or as your wallet or a shirt. They very beautifully advertise in the digital platform saying there's only two left in the stock. You order for one, okay? Again, the system says two left in the stock. This is one example. Second is deal of the day, okay? Tomorrow, Flipkart is going to launch EMI. So it's a, people will be eagerly waiting. They create a scarcity in the mind of the customer. And customer is hunger to get this product. Let me get this product from this particular platform. So that is something scarcity is created in the online market. Whereas in offline market, it doesn't happen. The person will keep it aside. In Amazon, you can't say, main tera loyal customer ho, mere liye nikal ke rakh. No, you can't do that. No, that is where the marketer creates a scarcity in online market. One, consumer wear. The first point, is it clear, students? First part, scarcity. Now there is something called as popularity. Okay, when I say popularity, formerly known as bandwagon effect, consumers are more likely to purchase a brand that their friends or other many others like and use it. Okay, this is a key point over here. The most popular brand is category gathers more buyers. This is why many people send request to like their Facebook pages and why Amazon 5-star product reviews lead people to believe the great book or the CD. Popularity. Okay, many times if you see this, there are n number of likes in YouTube, there are n number of likes in Facebook, and there are, whenever you go for buying a product, be honestly, could you please answer this? How many of you check for the 5 stars and buy the product? Or as how many of you read the reviews and go for buying the product? Can you answer this? Anytime have you done this? Usko 5-star mila hai product? Yeah, Vishal. Yeah, okay. You checked for the rating and went for buying the product, Vishal?
Yes, sir. Rating and reviews.
Rating and reviews. Okay. Yeah. Srinidhi, you wanted to say something?
Yes, sir.
Well, you checked for the rating and reviews.
For the new product, no? After launch.
Yeah. Okay. Vishal, when you went for the rating and reviews and you bought the product, did that product work out really well for you?
Yes, many of the times.
Yeah. Many times. Okay, great. Vishal, I'll just continue the same question. Have you done this in the offline market anytime? No, right?
No, sir, no.
Yeah, maybe you could have asked your friends one or two, but not more than that. Yeah, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Whereas over here, Srinidhi and Vishal, thanks for adding the points over here. Now, I just asked Vishal, he checked for the rating and reviews. But the same thing could not be done by Vishal in the offline market. He could have asked one or two of his classmates or friends, far away friends, and they might have said good or bad. But over here, he's checking many reviews, more than 30 reviews he's checking. He's understanding from them what are the drawbacks, what are the advantages. And he says most of the times the product was good. Even Srinidhi says whenever there is a new launch, okay, and I want to buy the product, I go for checking the reviews and ratings. So this is something, a nice platform created in digital marketing, students. We can check for the popularity and only then we get into it. So this is something we call it as popularity. Is that clear? The second point, popularity. Then comes affinity. Affinity, when I say consumers are persuaded by the friends and family because they like and trust them. Okay, viral marketing is based on this principle. You are likely to watch a YouTube video when someone you trust sends a link to you to purchase something that you are doing in the social network price. Okay. Now, this is quite interesting, students. Okay. Now, Morning Fires has sent you a link. Okay. Yesterday, whatever we did the discussion. Okay. The link is available. You can check for the videos. That is what the Fires are mentioned in the morning message. I went into YouTube and I was checking. Okay. Why I went into YouTube and checked it? Because Faiz sir, he is my colleague and he has sent it. Now, maybe whenever you are getting confused with whatever we discussed yesterday about the project, you will immediately go to that link and check it. So that is what we call it as affinity. Affinity, when I say someone has recommended you and then you are getting into the site. Or else you would have not got into the site. Yeah, right? Okay, making sense? Many times your friend might have put a status. Please click on the link and check for the video. So you have a trust on your friend. Maybe he has put something good. Let me go into it and check it. So such thing, what you do, we call it as affinity. Is that clear, students, the term? What is affinity? Digital marketing with regard to consumer behavior. Okay. Then the next is consistency. Okay. When an individual holds particular belief and attitude about the product,
it is hard to change them. Also called cognitive consistency, this explains the habitual buying pattern of the consistency. Okay, now it also explains why you take a chance on Olive Oil recommended. If you like her, you don't like to dislike her products. This is quite interesting, students. Consistency, you are very much consistent or as a cognitive purchaser. Okay, just now Vishal and Srinidhi said, okay, others can also add. How many of you like buying the products only on Amazon? Okay. How many of you very specific about the product in Amazon is good when compared to Flipkart? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Could be yes, one sir. Or two. Yeah, many to pen down now. How many of you pen down now? How many of? Sorry, there is echo. How many of you feel that okay? Snapdeal is good. No, Myntra is good. How many of you feel Myntra is good? How many of you bought products from Myntra?
Very good, sir.
Yes, sir. Sometimes.
Except electronic items in it.
Okay. Now, Vishal, Srinidhi, and Shruti, you said, okay. Is it consistent in Snapdeal? No, right? Your transactions are not consistent in Snapdeal. Yeah, right? Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Okay. Yeah, right. So now Vishal, Shruti, and Srinidhi, you are very much consistent when it comes to Amazon when compared to the other side. Yeah, right. So this is what I'm trying to say, consistent. Okay. And sometimes I've seen this, the research was done by the company researchers, and they said that Ranbir Kapoor and Ali Bhatt, when they started promoting Flipkart, many people diverted to Flipkart. It has actually happened. So because of this influence of the brand ambassadors, okay, people change their mind. One. Second is few people don't even bother whoever is the brand ambassador. End of the day, my consistency level remains same. Okay, I'm going to buy it from this particular platform because I have a trust. Could be Vishal, Srinidhi, and Shruti could be a prime customers of Amazon, and they're getting a very good offers provided by Amazon, whereas someone else might be getting a very good offer provided by Flipkart. Okay, so could be one more reason. So this is what we call it as consistency. Clear, students? Then the next part is reciprocity. Okay. Now this is something meaning exchange, students. This is why free product samples in the grocery stores or 30 days free trial, okay, downloads tend to increase product sales and the item turn in the sampling period. Okay. When we say this, okay, here what happens? Okay. Exchange. Okay. You tend to buy the products. Okay. For the certain time, say, for example, I was just telling, I might have told you in the last year as well, premium products, or say, for example, exchange. A sample product is always one of the best product given by the marketer. Please understand this. Now, free antivirus trial package, what is given to you, you tend to use this product for 30 days. After that, you get used to this product. And immediately what you do is you go for buying the product immediately. So this is something that trial has made you to get into it. Okay. So this, why they are doing this, giving a free trial to you, the reason is they want to increase their sales. Okay, that's the main reason the marketer is doing. This cannot be done in offline market. You go to any shop and say, mujhe 30 days ka antivirus de de free. He'll literally push you out of the shop. Okay, he'll throw you out of the shop. The simple reason is he can't do this. But whereas in digital platform, yes, I can get into this. I can go for the trial pack. I can check for the product. If I'm happy about it, I'll make the purchase. Okay. So this is something a bit different what happens in digital platform when compared to the offline platform. Hope this helped how the characteristics changes on the digital platform when compared to online platform. Offline platform. Okay. Any questions, students, in these six points, please let me know. A very general question asked in the paper. Please remember, what is affinity in digital marketing interviews? Okay. A very important question for the interview. What is affinity in digital marketing interviews? If you're planning to make your career in Flipkart, Amazon, I'm just giving you a hint. If you're planning to make your career in Flipkart, Amazon, eBay, OLX, okay, Uber, such questions are very, very common. How the consumer behavior changes. So what is affinity? A very, very common question asked in the interview. Okay. Yeah. So hope this helped. Any questions, please let me know. The next part, I'll be doing it in the next class. Steps and process of online behavior. It remains the same, students. What you have been studying from the first year, problem recognition, information search. We'll plug in one example and we'll try to understand, or else the same thing. We'll do it tomorrow, not miss. So any questions for me, please let me know. Those who joined late, please type it as present in the chat box. Okay. That would be your attendance. Any questions, any ambiguity, please let me know. I'll stop here, students. I'll stop the recording as well.